The Ames, model 1832, was manufactured by the Ames Company for the U.S. military as sidearms for artillery men. It is a solid brass handle. It's got a 19-inch blade in a gladius style. It is sharpened on both ends and has a blood gully in the middle. It's pretty heavy for a personal weapon, which is why it didn't make it so popular among the troops, and it weighs in at 3 pounds. The generals, in their original decision for the design of this, was that it was the last means of defense for artillery men. And back then, you have to remember that it wasn't where they would fight from miles and miles away to shoot artillery, but they were right on the battlefield. And many times, they would be charged by people on horses, cavalry, in order to break up their artillery functions, and it was thought that these would be used to maybe be able to rip the underneath of bellies. As such, though, it was very practical. It did not see any kind of real combat. And if it had any usages in war, it was to be a weed whacker, to cut paths. It's not even good for what every modern soldier likes to do, dig holes and hide. It's just not designed for that. I'm sure that some of the techniques that are going to be demonstrated, they were never designed to use. In fact, in all the instruction manuals around, there is no actual usage on how to use this kind of a sidearm. So if a soldier wasn't trained in its proper usages, then I'm sure that it wasn't used in any way. And they were only issued one, there weren't issued two of them. And they were issued mainly to non-com commissioned officers, otherwise known as sergeants. First year they made 2,000. These are dated 1835, and in 1835 they made a vast improvement on the handle and the hilt by making it a solid piece. These have a well-designed grip with scales on them, and just the way that it fits right into the hand. You get a nice grip on it and get some nice swinging action out of it. So let's see how a modern day martial artist might use these antique swords from 1835.